In this video, I wanted to show you another way you could set up Strategy Builder to create strategies based around your ninza indicators. Someone left a comment that they were having trouble getting Strategy Builder to catch every signal that the Cosmik indicator from ninza was printing. And if you haven't checked out my in-depth guide on how to do this, highly recommend checking out that video. It's got step-by-step instructions. But once you're in Strategy Builder, keep clicking Next until you get to the Conditions and Actions page. I've got a couple of conditions set up so it will only take trades from 9:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m., just the first 1 hour of the open. These are my conditions for entering a short. Everything is exactly the same as in my in-depth tutorial video, except I've changed one feature. So under this condition, let's edit this. So you can see I've got my Renko King's Cosmik Z-TP indicator selected. Now I want to scroll down to the value plot. For the value plot, if you just load this indicator up as it is, the default settings would be trend vector. So under the value plot, you want to make sure that you select signal, trade. Now in the last video, for a short, I had less. This value plot is less than a numeric value of zero, which has worked fine for me with other ninza indicators. However, I used the cross below feature this time, and this works as well. Perhaps maybe it's more accurate. I'm not exactly sure, but I've selected cross below, look back period of one, which is what loads up standard when you select the cross below. Then under our miscellaneous folder, numeric value of zero. So when the signal trade value plot of the Cosmik indicator crosses below a numeric value of zero, it will enter a short. The way the indicators are coded, a negative one is a short and a positive one is a long. So a cross below zero would be in the negative one territory. That will trigger a short. And for the long conditions and actions, you want to do the exact same thing. You've got your Cosmik indicator selected. You want the value plot to be signal trade. And this time, cross above. Look back period of one, numeric value of zero. So the signal trade value plot crossing above zero will catch a positive one in the coding, which will trigger a long signal. So that's it. Go to next, go to finish. And then you want to test it out and make sure that it's working. So you load up some market replay data. Go into your strategies. Make sure you attach the strategy you just created. I've got it enabled. Now I've got this set to only trade from 9:30 to 10:30. So I'm just gonna run market replay for 9:30 to 10:30 from today, February 14th. I've got the Cosmik indicator loaded onto the chart, along with a couple others that I already had on there, like VWAP and a moving average, support and resistance radar. These red triangles are being printed from the Cosmik indicator. So I want to make sure that the strategy that I just attached is firing off a short right when these Cosmik indicators are printing. Just gonna speed it up here. There we had our first Cosmik signal, printed a red triangle, and the strategy auto-traded. The strategy caught that trade. So far it's working great. Here's our next Cosmik signal. We've got a green triangle. The strategy auto-traded right when this signal appeared. So the strategy caught that long Cosmik signal as well. You always want to double check and test your strategies in market replay. So there's 10:30. We only had two cosmic signals. Both went for at least 30 ticks of profit. That's what I had my tick profit set for. There's usually not that many cosmic signals in any given morning. The cosmic indicator prints fewer but more quality signals. Someone also asked me if I used Strategy Builder and Strategy Analyzer to optimize my settings with the Cosmik Z-TP indicator, specifically using the King-Renko bar type. So I'm using the same strategy for the Cosmik indicator that is detecting these cosmic triangle signals. This one I've got set to run from 2 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. to try to catch some of the afternoon moves. So first things first, I wanted to really see if these King-Renko bars were accurately detected in the strategy analyzer. Because as many of you know, if you try to use Renko bars or Unirenko or even the ninzarenko, the results are not accurate at all. And this King-Renko bar type from ninza is supposed to be able to be backtested with accurate results. So I uploaded the Cosmik strategy that trades from 2 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. These are the factory settings, which I later will try and optimize. I put a target of 80 ticks and a stop of 80 ticks, a 1-to-1 ratio. And I just wanted to test today to see if these results matched up with what actually happens if I run back market replay. I want to see if it's accurately recognizing these past historical trades, and I want to see if it's accurately taking these trades during the market replay and recognizing these cosmic signals when they happen. So according to these backtesting results for today, February 14th, it took three trades, 100% profitable, $16 in commission, almost $1,200. It took all long trades. So now I'm gonna load up the market replay data and play it back with this strategy attached to the chart to see what happens. So here I've got the market replay for today loaded right at 1:55 p.m., 5 minutes before the strategy will start at 2 p.m. Go into my strategies, it's attached to the chart. I wanna make sure my target and my stop are both at 80, and I want to enable this. Make sure the account is on playback. Now it shows enabled down here in the control panel. Got it sped up to 100 times. It's just about to hit 2 p.m. here. So we're at 2 p.m. There's our first signal triggered. Slow this down a little bit. So first signal worked. We got put into the trade right when the cosmic signal appeared, and it was a winner. So far, it is completely accurate to the strategy analyzer results. Here's our second trade. We got put in right when this green triangle appeared that the cosmic indicator is printing, and it also went to target. Two trades, two signals, two winners. It's spot on with the strategy analyzer results so far. We've got about 20 minutes left in the session before this strategy will turn off and stop trading. Here's the third trade, put us in right when this signal printed. Apparently I didn't have all of the market replay data, so it's gonna freeze there, but it's looking like the results are spot on and completely accurate. So now I can disconnect from the playback connection. And now that I know this is accurate, I can go about back testing a little further back and trying to optimize some of the parameters. So selecting the Cosmik indicator strategy that I created that trades from 2 p.m. to 3:30. Keep clicking next. I've added a couple of inputs and variables in the inputs and variables sections. I've added a trend. I can't edit it anymore, but I added a variable and I called it trend with a default of 30 and a minimum of 1. And I added another variable called stop, COS, for the Cosmik stop. Default of 60 and a minimum of 1. These defaults are the defaults that come with the indicator. I'll show you in a second here. But by adding these variables, we'll be able to customize them in Strategy Analyzer. So for the conditions and actions, for both the short set and the long set, we're going to do the same exact thing. So here's the short conditions for entering a short. I'm going to edit this condition for the Cosmik Z-TP indicator. Here I've got my Cosmik Z-TP. I'm going to scroll down to the parameters. So these are the two biggest parameters that you might want to customize: the multiplier trend and the multiplier stop. So under the parameters, you want to set. You want to set the multiplier trend to your user input that you created called trend. And for the offset multiplier stop, you want to set this to your user input, your Cosmik stop. Everything else stays the same. It's a cross below numeric value of 0 for the shorts. And just make sure you change those two parameters on the long set as well. So now in the Strategy Analyzer, instead of backtesting, we can go to Optimization. Now we can optimize the target, the stop, and also the multiplier trend and multiplier stop parameters within the Cosmik indicator. So for a target, maybe I'll check out 30 to 100, and for the stop, I'll check out 20 to 80. For the trend multiplier, check out 2 to 60. And for the stop, 4 to 120. I'm gonna check out the NASDAQ. I'm gonna leave it on the King Renko bars, 16 break size, 4 for the trend threshold. I'm gonna back test 1 month. January 8th through February 9th, 4 weeks, including commission is checked. I'm gonna optimize on max net profit, optimizer genetic. And again, if you haven't seen the other video that I did, it goes over all the details of doing this step by step. Generation size 50. Generations 10. And now I'm going to click run and see what happens. So we can see the results here. $5,500 after commissions, $509 in commissions. It took 93 trades, a little bit over 50% profitable. Our target and stop was just about exactly what I used today. And this wasn't even analyzing the results from today. It was the prior 4 weeks. So I was just kind of guessing on that 80 target, 80 stop. Seems to be a pretty good standard kind of setting for the price action that we've been having recently. for the trend and the multiplier stop, it's basically double. The default settings for the multiplier trend and multiplier stop on the Cosmik indicator are 30 and 60, and this is showing basically 60 and almost 120, so basically double the settings. That's just for this one brick size trend threshold bar type of the ninZa. We could test different size ninZa bars, endless possibilities. The drawdown is a little heavy on this, so I would be looking to find some different settings or a different time frame, different bar type, something to get this maximum drawdown a little bit less. That's a little too high for me. But it seems that the ninZa bars are able to be back tested and they are executing accurately with the strategy that I built to take these Cosmik signals that the Cosmik indicator is printing. So here's some other ideas. I'm just typing in numbers, playing around with it. Here's a brick size of 30 and a trend threshold of 30 as well for the ninZa bar. 80 tick target, 80 tick stop. I'm just leaving the default settings on the Cosmik indicator of 30 and 60. So this is for 4 weeks, trading only an hour and a half a day. The drawdown was cut in half pretty much, only 1600 instead of 3 grand. The percentage profitable went up by going to a slightly higher time frame, and still almost 3 grand after the commissions. So if I'm looking for the perfect size ninZa bar to trade on a particular instrument, I can use this strategy I built with Strategy Analyzer to try to find the best brick size and trend threshold for the ninZa as well. Not only just the settings for the indicator, but the setting for the bar type or the time frame that I want to trade as well. Just tried a time-based chart, a 1 minute NASDAQ chart, and this is the best one yet. Over 6,000 after commissions, maximum drawdown of only 1,000, 68% profitable, 38 trades over 4 weeks. That's not too bad, that's not too many trades. Just trading from 2 p.m. to 3:30. I could try a 15 minute if I want to take even less trades. Only $1,500, but the maximum drawdown was much less. 70% profitable. It only took 10 trades over 4 weeks. You know, you could try this with tick charts, volume charts, range charts, second charts, minute charts. The 3 minute chart did pretty well, $2,700 with only a $400 maximum drawdown, 69% profitable. Took 13 trades over the course of this 4 weeks. I'm just using the default settings still, and 80 tick target, 80 tick stop. So you can see the kind of never-ending rabbit hole you could go on, but none of this past performance is going to correlate with real-time forward testing. That's a whole nother ball game, but if you're back testing recent price action, it can help give you some good basic parameters you might want to be trying. I hope you got some good ideas for your own trading. Thanks for watching.